1 kilogram for 1 day, and supplier takes 3 days. So the idea is that before I ordering raw material, I should have at least 3 days, not only 3 days, at least 3 days before I order the raw material. Why? Because supplier will take time. And if I will not calculate the usage, then in that case, maybe I'm too late to order raw material. The time I order raw material, at that time I have some raw material available in my store department. But within, let's say, 1 day, my material will be finished. Then I have to wait for raw material and my production will be stopped. All right, if production stops, material will not be delivered to the customer on time. So you can lose your market. All right, so that's why we need to find out the usage. All right. Okay, next one is the lead time. Lead time means how long supplier will take to deliver raw material in your factory. Like as I gave example, like as my supplier takes 3 days. So my daily consumption, 1 kilograms, and it takes 3 days. So 1 kilograms multiplied by 3. So I should have at least 3 kilograms in my store department. So that's why we need to know the lead time. Supplier could take 3 days, 1 week, 1 month, depends how far your supplier is from your factory or your company. All right. The third one is a safety stock. All right. What does it mean, safety stocks? Safety stocks means, like I give you my example, I repeat the same example. I should have at least 3 kilograms in my store department, right? So, because supplier is taking 3 days. This is my expectations. This is the average time period is 3 days where supplier will deliver raw material in my factory. Let's say there is something wrong with supplier on the way. Some kinds of unfortunate incident or accident on the way come to the factory. So due to that accident, the material supply could be delayed. All right, if material supply could be delayed, you running out of material, you don't have material, you cannot produce product. So the idea is that we have to keep some kinds of backup. All right, so that's why I say that at least 3 kilograms, not exactly 3 kilograms. So let's say I can keep it 4 to 5 kilograms, even though my supplier taking 3 days, but I am assuming 4 to 5 days. All right, so in any case, if supplier will be delayed, 1 or 2 days delay. So still I have a material available in my factory. All right, so here I will not show you the calculation because we already done the calculation in the class activities. So keep in your mind the calculation that we are calculating for ordering points. So you need to know the usage multiplied by lead time. So that much raw material you required, but not only that much raw material required in your store department, plus a safety stocks. So the material required plus safety stocks will consider your order point. Let's say my usage multiplied by lead time is 3 kilograms, and I think my safety stock should be 1. So 3 plus 4. So 4 kilograms. Alright? So if my raw material full of, if my store department full of raw material to the 10 kilograms, then my raw material reach at 6 kilograms because my order point is 4. So when my raw material reach at 6 kilograms, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Alright? Then it's time to order. 6 kilograms finished, 4 kilograms left, 4 kilograms is my order point, I will order at that point. That's the meaning of order. Alright. Next one is EOQ. EOQ stands for, E stands for economic, O stands for order, and Q stands for quantity. Economic, order, quantity. So means what is the right quantity to order the raw material. What does it mean? So in economic, or before we look at economic order quantity, we need to understand two types of cost associated with material. The first one is a carrying cost, and another one is a ordering cost, right? Carrying cost and the ordering cost. Carrying cost means we also call it holding cost. When we hold the raw material, we have to spend money to take care of it, such as electricity, could be a rent, could be security guard, could be ventilation system, could be clean or manage the store department or the raw material. So we have to spend money on it. So that's the money, whatever we are spending, is called carrying cost. So the, so keep in your mind, if we, you buy too much raw material, your carrying cost will be high because high maintenance, right? If you buy low, you have a low carrying cost. Ordering cost means the cost of ordered raw material, right? So if you buy a small quantity of raw material each and every time, your order cost will be increased. If you buy the large quantity of raw material at one time, so means you have to order less throughout the period, throughout the year. So you're not gonna spend too much on your ordering raw material, right? So I would say that there is a negative relations between ordering cost and carrying cost, right? If carrying cost is high, ordering cost is low. If ordering cost is low, if ordering cost is high, carrying cost will be low. So there is a negative relation. They are not equal, all right? So how we can solve these problems? Because if we hold too much, we control the ordering cost, but our carrying cost will be increased. So the solution of this problem is EOQ, economic order quantity. Means the right point to order the raw material. If we go beyond this, that if we go beyond that point, our either ordering cost or carrying cost will be increased. So, as you can see in the class, I drew a small graph for the ordering cost and carrying cost. I quickly repeat that cost here, the graph here. So this is your carrying cost. And that is your ordering cost, and that is your quantity, and y-axis is your cost, all right? Okay, so you can see that this is your carrying cost, this is your ordering cost, and this point where they meet, that point is your EOQ. Alright, because means you should order that much quantity with that much price. Alright, if you go beyond this point, let's say if you go on the right hand side, alright, your carrying cost will increase. Alright, if you go less, means this side, your ordering cost will increase. So that this is the right point to order, all right? So now the question is, how do we calculate economic order quantity? As per your slides, we have a formula as well. So the formula for economic order quantity is, there is a square root 2cn divided by k, all right? So C stands for cost of order. So I will say that ordering cost. Alright, N stands for number of units required annually. Means how many units company need to produce product. Alright, and K stands for carrying cost. But carrying cost per units annually. Alright, per units annually. This is annual. Annual means yearly. Alright? So this is the ideas to calculate the economic order quantity. Whatever quantity we will get it by applying this formula, that quantity we should order. Alright? Each and every time. Alright? If you try to enhance the value from that EOQ, your carrying cost will increase because the size of quantity increase, your carrying cost increase. If you will try to minimize the quantity from EOQ point, then your overall quantity will be reduced for per order. So your finally, your annual order, number of orders in 1 year will be increased. So in both cases, your cost will be increased. So EOQ is the right point to measure or estimate the quantity that we should order every time. All right. So this is called EOQ, economic order quantity. So your first learning outcome is finished. All right. So now we move on to the second learning outcome. All right. Which is your inventory control procedure. Okay, so the second learning outcome, so this is your topic two. So now we're gonna talk about learning outcome two. So learning outcome two is about the material control procedure. Material control procedure. Alright, material control procedure means what is the procedure to order, receive, and consume raw material. So we're going to talk about the three things here. Alright, so first one is the order, second one is a receive, and third one is consume. Right. Order raw material. If you want to know about all these three things, we have to make a small diagram which can relate a connection among all the department who involve into ordering, receiving, and consuming raw material. Alright. So I give you a very short and quick diagram. The diagram I draw in the class, same diagram, I will repeat it here, but a little bit fast because of running out of time. Alright. So we have mainly four departments. Here is the store department.